Hello? I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a girl who looked good. I would call.
We're not texting you, guys. I'm playing with my drink. I'm just drinking. That's it, right? You're allowed to drink and drive, but you're not allowed to, you're allowed to have a drink while you're driving.
Gonna rephrase your words.
Morning, brother. How you doing?
Good. How are you, my man?
Excellent, sir.
Do you care if I have you on camera? Because I'm fucking always recording everything.
No, it's all good. I don't care. It's all good, brother.
Fuck, I want to come see that thing today. Can I?
Okay, cool.
I'm itching, bro. I'm not fucking playing around anymore. I want it.
Let me just go check right now. If it's back yet before you come back again.
Perfect.
Let me just double check outside, because if not, then I'll go up to the shop and bring it down.
Perfect.
Just looking outside. Yeah, it's not here yet, so I'm going to call the shop.
Okay.
And see if we can bring it down, and then I can give you a call right back.
Perfect. Now, I'm just going to ask you straight up. If I buy that fucking thing, can I take it home, or do you guys got to do a bunch of bullshit first?
No, as I told you on the inspection, it's clean. So pretty much it needs nothing. We just need your money, and then you can have your car.
I like that. I like that mindset, bro. I bet. I'm going to go get a deposit for it, and then I'll come in and you'll talk numbers and shit.
I'm going to go to the shop right now, and I'll let you know. Give me 10 minutes.
Cool. Thanks, dog.
No problem, brother.
Bye. All right, guys. That's my boy Costa. Up at August Motors, August Luxury Motors. All right, we'll show a little splash of that to show you guys what I'm talking about, because your boy is gonna go pick up another whip today. All right, you thought I was just gonna stop at the fucking R8. You guys are literally dreaming. I need a winter car. I can't drive this all winter, so it was an excuse for me to buy another whip. That's why I didn't originally get a different car. That's how it works, Daniel.
100%.
Right? That's how it works. I gotta get a winter car. At least that's what I'm telling Julia. I gotta get a winter car. All right, taking the bus. In a way, I'm going to be all right in the summer, that bus in the winter. It's time, bro. We're going to get the other whip.
Let's go.
Let's go. So the check is secured. All right, we've got around an hour, if I'm not mistaken. It is 11:43. Technically, I've got a haircut at 1. Let's go see if we can see the whip, put the money down on the whip, and get the whip before we get our haircut. Let's go. You guys are watching the vlog right now. Let me know what you think. Do you think that landing on the moon was bullshit? Listen, I'm not big on getting into conspiracy theories, but how the fuck did we get there so long ago, but we haven't been able to get there since? Explain that to me, Daniel.
My explanation is this. So I get where you're coming from. I don't believe that we got to the moon as quick as we say we did, just because we wanted to beat the Russians, first of all. Because the Russians were the first people to go in space, and I think those motherfuckers definitely went there.
But you believe that we've been there?
I believe that we have, and I think the reason that we haven't been back is something that they're not telling us. Like some fucked up shit.
Like
I believe in aliens. I believe in aliens.
So you believe in fucking aliens, but you don't believe that?
I don't believe in, like, I don't
film yourself.
I don't necessarily think that aliens are like weird looking green objects. They could look just like us.
Yeah.
Or they could look something like completely different. But there, you can't tell me that there isn't other things.
No, I agree.
Out there.
I agree.
You know what I mean?
But I don't believe we've ever been to the moon. There's no fucking way.
Fair. You have the right to your own opinion, bro.
No, it's fucking facts. Dude, the fact that we have the technology to create all this AI shit and everything that we have today. We have self-driving fucking cars. We have the most crazy technology ever. And now we're just thinking about going back. Get the fuck out of here, bro.
But that's
And their excuse is bullshit. It's too expensive. We spend billions of fucking dollars every year on dumb shit. You know the green circle in Calgary? Have you ever seen it?
The green circle?
There's a green circle in Calgary. You can look it up. And it's on a bridge near the airport that costs $3 million. And all it is a steel fucking circle. That's the art they put up.
That sounds like bullshit to me.
Not bullshit, bro. There's no way.
Bro, what do you think about like the satellites and all the things getting shot up into space?
Yeah, that's fine to me. I don't give a fuck about any of that shit. Like shooting stuff into space, that's okay.
What about
all the way to the moon, I think is bullshit. You believing that people have been to the moon is just like you believing that this guy looks cool on that fucking scooter. No. Absolutely not.
Oh my god.
Okay? Pistol for my sanity, lying, say I'm living fast for me. I let them run and heal themselves. Where's my baby? Where's my baby, bro? What you hating me is missing in you. Where's she at? Give me my whip, dog. 3 weeks. Supermodel suck me clean. Next. I love my little knee freaks. Everyone on my team eats. I employ my comrades. No one's looking at. All right. What's up, BG?
Hi, buddy.
How are you?
Good timing.
Oh, you know.
You sent a message like 5 minutes ago.
Yeah. I moved my haircut because I was like, I want to come down.
It's all good.
All right.
Come on in. He's actually, I'm going to just bring my beat while he's just finishing it up.
They're getting rid of it?
No, they're going to be
going
to the track on our track
8
September. So they brought it up from Cali.
The whole fucking thing?
Yeah. You've heard of these guys, right?
Oh, yeah. I watched a couple of the videos. I didn't know who they were until I saw you guys.
Yeah, yeah.
But, like, what?
Should
the
be.
Fuck?
Hold on. It's a little.
You see what's the other side?
Yeah,
this thing's insane, dude. Oh, yeah. This is the spider I saw. Hold on. See, I've never been like a convertible fan, bro, but I'm not gonna lie, this is pretty fucking lit. Traded in my R8 for this one? Okay. All right, what you guys think? Do you like my R8 more, or do you like the spider more? All right, I'm gonna do a little bit of B-roll of my R8 so you guys can see, and then a little bit of B-roll of this one, and then I want you to tell me spider or regular in the comments below. Oh my god, so it's like, it's literally like a race car.
Thing's so fucking fast, it's got a crotch seat though. It's like you're getting in a fucking airplane. This is just even. I didn't even touch a button.
What the fuck?
I literally sat down and it's like, it started singing to me.
It's about to start.
This thing's hard to get in. I couldn't imagine. If you're big, I am 5'6", 172 pounds, or 171 pounds, and it's as hard for me to get in. Get in there, Danny.
There's no way.
Dude, I don't think there is.
There's physically no way you're getting in that car. If you get stuck, you're buying it.
No, there's no way, bro.
Yeah, I can't. Because even if I sunk myself in from the side, there's no way I can twist myself in.
Yeah.
Should I do the ckin multiple times?
Yeah, we sat in this.
Yeah.
The last time we were here?
Yeah, but I need winter cars because we don't live in a fucking place where you can only drive supercars and things that are super low to the ground. Or this C10 would also be on the fucking list. Why we need a summer house. This is why we need a fucking house in a place that has no snow. Videos ready, bro. We post no matter what.
Here we go.
Everywhere. Ejector sheet. Shoots into the fucking ceiling. Oh my god. I told them that you did it. I think.
What?
Oh yeah, I blame it on you instantly.
Bro, that's not fair.
I'm not taking the blame.
You put money in here. I haven't. They'll probably blacklist me.
Daniel, this is what we're getting.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Does the hatchet come with it too?
Winter car. Fucking army jeep. Yeah.
Just
wear a fucking snowsuit.
And you get
in the winter, and there we go.
You get a hatchet with it too.
Yeah.
Or not a hatchet, a full-on axe.
Yeah. And if you can't put it down, you can just burn it down.
Beast. Yes, a car that actually can seat me.
Do you want to be away from the traffic?
Yeah.
Then go right.
Oh, go right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Figure then you can take it a little bit more.
Oh, yeah.
That's very nice.
I've never seen the fucking green / like gold outside.
The nice thing too, this one's got the matte wrap.
Yeah.
So it's given already that flat look of the military style.
High-end Elantra.
Right here?
Yeah, you can, sorry, bust it right here.
Feel the seats hug you yet?
Yeah.
Right? That's cool, eh?
That's
yeah.
Nice. Every time, yeah, especially when you go at high speed, it's just like, oh, yeah. Who's there massaging me?
It's like a love tap.
Obviously. And then, yeah, I'm going to put on some massaging and seats on you guys, so you guys can get a full-on massage as you're driving.
No way.
Yeah.
Come on. There you go. All right. Woo. Get ready, boys.
Oh, my God.
All right, Dan. It's time to pick off, dog. Fucking crazy. This thing's so sick. Oh, it's fucking awesome.
Not bad, eh?
I'm obsessed. This is like years in the making, bro.
I know, you've been working hard for it.
Dream car, bro, for a long time. Really long time. I remember seeing when I was like 15 years old or something. 16
yeah.
years old. It was like, that thing's sick. And now it's all coming together.
Wasn't it pinned up on the wall? I was like, yeah, this is going to be my future vehicle one day.
Like one of the poster people where it was like, let me put a poster up and fucking like do that, but it was always like one day that'll happen, bro. Yeah,
nice.
Like the R8, I remember watching it was like a kid's movie with my little brother.
Yeah,
it's called what the fuck was it, 17 ckin again or something.
Yeah.
With Zac Efron. I watched it with my baby brother. And I watched the RA pull up, the gold one or the silver one.
Yeah.
I remember looking at my little brother and being like, one day I'll be driving one of those things. And I remember the day that I got it, I sent him a video like, what the fuck?
And he's
like,
oh shit. It.
Yeah. I was like, now the G-Wagons are coming, thing, bro. I'm like, fucking insane.
Hey, putting dreams to reality. Yeah. I love it, man.
Let's fucking see if this is all good to go.
Okay.
Let's just see if it's approved, bro. I'm gonna say this very plainly. If you want a trainer in person, that's fine. Do not fucking take Tren. Whoever told you to do that is an idiot. This is the thing. If you want to take any steroids, they should be testosterone. What you could do is you could talk to a doctor and up your dosages. Now, I'm not gonna sit here and pretend that I am an expert in performance enhancing drugs, PEDs, steroids, whatever the fuck you want to call them and define them as. But Tren is one of the worst steroids that you could fucking take for your body. It is savage on your system. It's great for bodybuilding. It'll put on a lot of muscle for you. It'll make you look jacked out of your fucking mind because a lot of bodybuilders utilize it to make them lean while growing size. But it is also extremely hard on your fucking system, bro. Like, I know the only people I know that take Tren are people who step on IFBB Pro, like, bodybuilding stages or who are trying to become IFBB pros. She's a bodybuilder who wants you to take Tren because she doesn't understand how to fucking diet people properly and look you in your face and say verbatim, if you want to build muscle and you want to do it naturally, you're going to have to spend at least 2 to 3 fucking years going through a proper building phase with a proper caloric surplus and training, like I will tell you to your face, you feel me? One of my fucking one-on-one clients that I help with his mindset, who is actually just going through addiction recovery, wants to get a trainer in person as well as us doing training online because he wants to work on his form, and at the end of the day, if he's got the money, who gives a fuck, go do your thing. Don't bother me. First thing the fucking trainer says, he's only talked to her today, walks in and tells her, my goal is to put on muscle and build a more defined physique, and she's like, why don't you just take Tren? Like, if you take Tren, you'll really build up a lot of muscle. Like, you'll look a lot more dense and thick. Fucking idiots. If you are a fitness coach or a personal trainer and your instant recommendation for an individual looking to put on muscle is take steroids, fuck you. Baby, baby, why'd you call me out my name? Cause now I need it and I might just do the same.
Fucking
extinct,
man.
Can't
work, can't leave your house, can't fucking
see
your mom.
Thank you.
All right.
Hey, boss. Have a good one. I'll see you soon.
Later, man.
Peace, boys.
Yeah, I really like it.
What's the plan, Stan? You get a text back?
Well, I got a couple texts back, but I needed to send some information, so we shall see. Ooh. I swear to God, if I can't get it today, I'm gonna lose my fucking mind, bro. Because that means this vlog doesn't get finished until the end of the month. Because I'm gone until the 26th of August.
Oh my God.
It is the fucking 16th. No stress, bro.
Chair.
Yep.
Are you reachable this next little while you're gone?
Oh yeah, you can shoot me a text. Okay. It's just like the weekend I'm busy, and then what's called next week I'm going to see my grandma in my hometown. So it's not like I'm like out of the country. I'm just on the other side of the country.
Okay, no worries. We'll bounce back and forth via text as soon as if I have any questions for you, and text me your email when you have a chance, and then we'll go from there.
Perfect, bro. Sounds good.
All right, my man. I'll keep you posted as soon as I know something.
All right, I'll talk to you in a bit.
Sounds good, brother.
Okay, bye.
Ciao.
Motherfucker, dude. Of course.
No, I don't even want it anymore. Made me wait? I don't even want it anymore, bro. Just keep the fucking car.
Fine. All right, we now need to wait until the 26th of August. It is the 16th. Tomorrow we fly out to Toronto to watch Brian step on stage, which I'm actually super fucking excited about. So it's not like we're gonna be like sitting there just waiting. I've got like a very packed week because tomorrow we fly to Toronto, Ontario to watch Brian step on stage. And then I actually get to go see my grandma, which I'm super excited for. I haven't seen her in a long time. And the entire point of us going to Thunder Bay, Ontario, after we go to Toronto, Ontario, is so that my son can meet my grandma, because my grandma's actually everything. So I'm going to piece in a little clip here of when my grandma sees and meets Cade for the first time ever. And then we'll fast forward to the end of the month to finish off this vlog to show you guys the dream whip that I've always wanted. And then to talk to you guys about like what it truly means to me.
Hi.
Oh, I look at the smile. You're so adorable.
Yeah, yes. It's a little boy, me one more cream.
And we're back. Guys, there's been a lot that's fucking happened over the last little bit, all right? The last scene you guys saw was me and Daniel downtown waiting to see if I could go pick up my whip, which I'm so fucking excited for, and we couldn't pick it up. That was, I'm pretty sure, 14 days ago. That was like the 24th of August, somewhere around there. I think that was actually the 23rd of August, because on the 24th of August, was that even before then? Bro, when did we leave, Daniel?
Like the 17th.
The 17th? Holy fuck, dude. It's been like a solid fucking like almost 2.5 weeks, bro. So like the 17th is when we left, guys. And the 17th or 18th, Kelowna set on fire. Check this shit out.
West Kelowna was ablaze, but most tragically, what appears to be structures on fire, fully involved. The people where we are now went from safely watching from across the lake to frantically evacuating themselves. We witnessed embers jump from the west side across to the east side of the lake where we are here. It was chaotic and emotions were high.
So, well, I'm glad my fucking house and my gym didn't burn to the fucking ground. And I'm glad that my family and Daniel and my puppy and everybody else is fucking safe, because that was insane. All right, it was actually fucking mental. I wasn't even here. Daniel was here, and he said that he couldn't even fucking go outside without like wanting to puke because of the fucking air, right?
Yeah, well, I did puke when I was inside even too, bro.
Absolutely fucked. Like, I got here yesterday and was pissed that it was smoky here, and it's not even smoky here. It was like, it's so much better.
Yeah.
Like, you mean it's better, bro?
It's but so much better.
Apparently, it's so much better. Regardless, it's been a long, long fucking month, basically, since we've been gone. We did Toronto, watch Brian step on stage, where he won first place. Let's fucking go. I then went to Thunder Bay, and I showed Julia my home country house, which I'll talk to you guys about in the next fucking vlog. It's gonna be a deep one. We then flew to New York City because we didn't want to come back to the inferno that was fucking Kelowna. And New York City was absolutely fucking amazing. Let me show you guys some of the clips from New York City super quick. And now it's time to go get my fucking whip. I cannot wait to show you guys. We will announce what the car is once we get there. Buckle the fuck up. This is gonna be dope.
You guys got a bow on it?
Yeah, you want a bow on it or not?
Bow on it, dude.
If you want, I can take it off.
No, that's good. That doesn't bother me.
Look, because when we're going to take the wrap off, it's going to fly off.
It's for you, Daniel.
Yeah,
I love the bow.
He loves the bow.
I love the bow.
Sweet, I get the bow?
Yeah, bro.
Put it on my head.
All right, guys, so showed you last time that we came, all right? Haven't shown you the car yet. Super fucking excited. This has been something that I've wanted since I was like 12 years old, and it is officially becoming a reality. So
let's check it out. Let's do it. Here it is, the new fucking whip. Yeah. How sexy that motherfucker is, bro, eh? Right?
How do you feel about the new whip?
Honestly, it's the best fucking thing in the entire world. Couldn't ask for anything more. The air conditioning's lit. I love the feel of it. The seats are super comfortable. It's almost like they've been sat in for fucking 10 years. The brakes and the steering is like perfectly aligned with the side of the road. Honestly, it's been a long time in the making. I just remember as a kid sitting there talking to my younger brothers about how one day I'd be able to afford an Elantra, and now it's become a reality.
Every day I'm hustling. Every day I'm hustling, 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 every day I'm, every day I'm, every day I'm hustling.
Let's go like this first. First we gotta open up the windows. First we gotta open up the windows. Why? Because without the windows open, you can't hear it. You can't hear it. So now let's start it up. That sounds so good, man. That sounds so fucking good. It's not even funny. All right, let's look at this. Sport mode 2, wait for it. Wait for it, Daniel. Let's see here. I still gotta learn this motherfucker, dude. As you guys can see, I'm sitting in my brand new AMG G63, the G-Wagon, the car that I have literally wanted since I was like 12 to 15 years old. This has been a dream of mine for so fucking long, it's not even funny. I've talked about this to Julia, I've talked about this to Brian, I've talked about this to Daniel, I've talked about this to so many fucking people, to my social media, to my little brothers, and now it is a reality. So
honestly, I'm going to let the emotions sit with me for a while because I don't want to rush this explanation. I don't want to rush this video. I don't want to rush the emotions that I am currently feeling. So make sure you subscribe to the channel because in the next video, I'm going to talk to you guys about how when I was a kid, I grew up in a fucking trailer, a 600 to 900 square foot trailer, 45 minutes into the country outside of Thunder Bay, Ontario, which by the way, I went and took photos of like a fucking creep when I was back in Thunder Bay with Julia. So I'm gonna walk you guys through that. So subscribe to the fucking channel because I wanna show you guys slash explain what I've done in order to become this person, but also just kind of give you some insight into what I have done from the age of 14 to 29 to go from a 600 to 900 foot trailer out in the country, struggling for money, growing up fucking nothing, to a 29 year old just buying my second fucking dream car. This is dope. Very happy, very blessed. All right, excited to fucking roll around with Daniel and do some fucking videos in this beast.
Let's go.
Hey, this is lit.
Yeah, it's gonna be sweet,
it's
bro.
Even got TVs in the back for Daniel yeah. when he gets tired.
Yeah, go take a nap back
and
there.
And the fucking, the film is still on the motherfuckers because they're brand new, dog. We blessed, bro.
Let's go.
We blessed. Guys, subscribe. Stay tuned for the next video. It's gonna be a fucking deep one. Me and Daniel will get that out ready for you guys. I love y'all. Thank you so much for the fucking support. Hopefully you get some motivation, inspiration, value, and more from this channel. Peace.